Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah, church. I'm happy to be here. I thank God. I thank Bishop and Mark for this opportunity. And I thank God who have managed to come this morning. God bless you.
Amen.
Today, we're going to share the word of God, which has no means to say that. Testify that you are Christian. Amen.
Amen.
This is a topic where nowadays Christians has been like other people. But nowadays I want us to change our behavior. I want us to change our conduct, our doctrines, so that people they can know that we have Jesus Christ, we have received Jesus Christ as a Christian. You know, when you say that you're a Christian, and other people they are looking at us, they don't see any difference. It's like you are walking God himself. But because we have known him, we need to testify to the one you see. Amen. This word Christians, it was given by the Greeks or Romans to the followers of Jesus. And it was used the first in Antioch. You can read that from the Acts of Apostles, chapter 11, verse 6. But before they were known among the disciples who were perfect, faithful, elect, and believers. That was the name which was used in that time. But after that, people they have realized, these people they are doing good, these people they are behaving like Christians, these people they are the same with Jesus Christ himself. So they changed their names. They stopped calling them believers, they stopped calling them, they start telling them, yes, now they are Christians. Amen. So we need to do the same as ourselves. We need to receive Jesus Christ so that we can know, people they can know that we have received a greater man. Amen. Christians means that it's a real disciple of Christ, one who believes in the truth of the Christians, the religion, and studies, they follow the example and obey the precepts or principles of Christ. A believer in Christ who is characterized by real piety or real righteousness. So as a Christian, you need to be righteous, you need to be right, you need to be correct every time. Because Jesus himself was a holy person. The Bible says in the book of 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 16, it says, be holy as I am holy. God himself is holy, and those who serve him must be like him. Hallelujah. Now we can even wonder what is the testify. The word testify. The word testify says that to bear witness, to support the truth of by the testimony, to affirm or to declare the gospel of the grace of God. It's to speak that you know or you testify the person whom you know. Amen. Because when you say, when a person asks you, who is Jesus? Sometimes you can say, Jesus is God. But how will they know that if you are Christian? This is through your conduct, through your characters. Amen. You must know that we are the epistles of our church, and known and read by everyone. Where we go outside, we are representative of our church, we are representative of Jesus Christ himself. So when you are being known outside there, actually you are praying the church where you go to pray, and you are praying Jesus Christ whom we knew. Amen. Let us read the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 11. Ecclesiastes, chapter 11, verse 9 and 10. It says, rejoice, O young man, in your youth, and let your heart cheer in the days of your youth. Walk in the ways of your heart, and in the sight of your eyes. eyes, but know that all this good will bring you into judgment. Therefore, remove sorrow from your heart and put away evil from your flesh, for childhood and youth are vanity. Amen. As young men ourselves, we have to know that to enjoy the life or to do something outside there, it's good to us because we are still alive. But in order, everything you do, whether good or bad, at the end of the time, it will bring it on judgment. Amen? And it says that the child and you, it's vanity. There is nothing we need to enjoy from that. We need to just testify God. We need to testify Jesus Christ. We need to reach out to people. We need to share the word of God because we knew whom we know. Amen? Continuing the chapter 12, verse 1. And it says, remember now your creator, in the days of your youth, before the difficult days come, and the years draw near, when you say, I have no pleasure in them. Verse 13, let us have the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandment, for this is man's all. For God will bring every work into judgment, including every secret thing, whether good or evil. Amen? There is some 8 factors which will show us that you are Christian. And the first is forgiveness. This is a word which actually comes up every Sunday or every service. That forgive. This means that as Christians, we need to forgive, we need to have that heart which is able to forgive our brother, which is able to forbear people. Because if we are not forgiving people, even those who are outside, they don't forgive. If we are not able to forbear our brothers, even those who are ungodly, they don't do that. So as Christians, to testify that we are Christians, we need to have such pardon, and you say that, me, yes, you have done wrong to me, but because the person I knew, because Jesus Christ, I'm able to forgive you. Amen? You can read the book of Mark chapter 11, verse 25 and 26. The second one is reconciliation. After forgive, it's not enough. Because you can say, Fabrice, I've forgiven you, but I will not talk to you anymore. That's not a forgiveness. It means you still have some bitterness in you. And when you say, I forgive you, just because if you were talking before, let's continue. Because if you are Christians, it's not just come all to go and sleep and know in the morning you wake up. No. This thing of Christianity, you have to take it carefully. Amen? You can read the Hosea chapter 3 verse 1. This is also a big burden. Imagine Hosea, his wife became a whole immoral person, became a prostitute. But God told him, you have to forgive your wife and bring her back. Not only forgive her and bring her back. You can read it. Hosea chapter 3 verse 1. Then the Lord told me, go love your wife again. Even though she's being loved by another and is committing adultery, love her the same way the Lord loves the people of Israel. Amen? So this shows that forgiveness is not enough, but forgive and reconcile people. That will show people that you are really Christian. Romans chapter 5 verse 10 says, for if while you are enemies, you are reconciled to God through the death of his Son, how much more have you been reconciled to be saved by his life? We are doing all of this not because of sin, because of Jesus Christ. Because of him, we need to forgive, we need to conceive one another. Amen? Number 3, which will help us, or which will show people that you are living with Christian, is to be content or to be satisfied with the way we are. Philippians chapter 4 verse 1, it says, learn to be content in all situations you are in. Learn to be content. If you say today I don't have money, learn to be content. get that bad work hard so that you can get what you want. Amen. Because if you are gorgeous, you'll be peaceful. But if you say, I have problems, every day I have problems, every day I have problems, you don't have peace in you. You just feel like there's people sitting every day. But if you say, no, I'm satisfied, it's okay. God will cause you to get it anymore. Hallelujah. Number four, be light and just. Don't lie, don't gossip, don't see, stand corrected. Avoid all kind of corruption. Amen. This is the year of explosion. This is Daniel chapter 11 verse 2. When we start their beginning, it says, those who do wicked against the covenant. Those who do wicked against the covenant. Those who do bad things, those who do evil things, they shall corrupt by flatteries. All school for, you know, nowadays Christians, they have become like these holy people. You tell them, you know, you have done wrong. He became very bitter. He doesn't want to know what is wrong as that. He said, okay, if I learn wrong, just keep quiet. No, Christian must not be like that. If I did wrong, correct me. It's the way we say, this man has done well, this man has done bad. So that, how will I know that I'm doing bad, and you are not talking to me, what you have done? Maybe me, I think what I'm doing is right, but it's not right. Tell me as a brother or a sister, tell me Fabrice, this you are doing is too wrong. So that I can be great. Amen? But today, nowadays, like testimonies, I like to say the truth. But as a person, this is, you know, Fabrice, every truth is not necessary. But Bible says, say the truth, because the truth is very hard. You need to say the truth, because if you don't know that, devil has already defined ourselves, has defined us to justify that you are Christian. You want to say, hey, this is, no, you know, this altar, maybe you see it's bad, but you say, hey, it's very good. If it's bad, say it's bad, because it's bad. But if it's good, say it's this. Amen? So it's better not to be corrupted by this move forward, or to say, oh, tell me good things only. No, that's not a Christian. If I have done good, you will find. If I have done wrong, you will correct me. Hallelujah. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 27 to 28. It says, a hopeless person, cannot evil gossip, his lips are like a burning fire. This means that as a Christian, as a young man, as a youth, we don't need to gossip each other. We don't need to gossip because these are not for Christians. There's no way you show your friend that you are Christians and you are at work every day. You know, in our church, this man has done this and this and this and this. And you want to tell him to come to our church. And you are told him, this church is very bad. You are gossiping for nothing. And his uncle is a person is asking him, oh, how is your church? I said, you know our church? Our church is smaller, our church, they're not here, people, they don't greet each other. There are many things bad. Actually, he's not asking you how is that, how is your church? He's asking you, how is you in your church? So what the answer I'm giving you, it's you saying, hey, in our church, I don't have love, I don't care, I don't come to service, I don't come in the morning prayer, I don't have the success. That's the answer I'm giving you, brothers. And maybe he was asking you to want to change. But because what you are saying, he can't be changed. So we need to be sure what you are, what you talk outside there. Chapter 20, verse 19 in Proverbs, it says, whoever secret gossip betrays confidence. So don't get involved with someone who talks too much. If you see, you know, this world, all of us are not Christian. So it might be possible that you have some friends who are not born again, who doesn't know Jesus Christ. So when it's like that, try to hold your tongue, try to hold your lips. Don't talk too much to them. Because if you do that, you might be corrupted. Or when they're doing something wrong, tell them they're doing wrong. Or keep quiet. Or leave you. That will help you to stand in a good relationship with Jesus Christ. Number five, Bible says, be merciful or have compassion in you. A true Christian, when you are merciful, when you have a compassion to the people, when you read the Bible, I'm looking for this compassion. See, God have compassion upon Jesus Christ, my brother, like that. Compassion is very important to us Christians. When you see people outside there, just have mercy upon them. If you are able to touch them, if you are able to help them, if you are able to share with them the word of God, do it, because you don't know what will touch you. Hallelujah. So therefore be merciful. Number six, avoid pride in you and talk as a Christian. Avoid pride in you. As a Christian, let us avoid pride. Let us, whatever we do, not do it for ourselves, but for God. For God. Let's say, you know, various people have said, Sunday I will dress nicely, but during the week I will wear the way I want. I don't care. You have to care. Because Christians must care. This Christianity is a sacrifice. It's not about our will. It's the will of God. So don't say I'm a Christian on Sunday, but during the next 6 days I will not a Christian. How will we born again? How will we win the souls? If you cannot bear the fruits outside there. So as I move, let us walk on this. Let's avoid pride. Pride is very bad and it's very dangerous. Proverbs chapter 8 verse 13 says, the fear of the Lord is the end of evil blood. Arrogance on evil lifestyle and perverted speech I despise. Well, it's a devising us, just a device. Despise all of this. Despise arrogance, despise pride, despise evil lifestyle, because these are not for us. These are for these people are good. Just whatever you do, do to testify unto your Christian. Whoever will see you, say this apostle is a Christian. You know, nowadays, if you go to the Muslims, you will know that they are Muslims because they are the Muslims. But us, let us be. Let us have identity of our behavior, all our character. Says this person, he is very Christian for our character. Because they will make their peace. They have made their clothes. If you see them, you have this person is a Muslim. But us, let us sanctify our character and God. Amen. The fear of the Lord is to let evil, blind, arrogance, and evil lifestyle, and habit speech. That's what we despise. The fear of the Lord is a person who is fearing. He doesn't do this. Number seven, it says, sacrifice and listen to the voice of God and be example to the others. Sacrifice. I give you just a short testimony about sacrifice. You remember the time we went in the Rwanda, Bishop and Mom, they went there. But they had something good which is beyond sacrifice. My father is in jail. They went fasting. They didn't even have enough time to sleep. But in the morning, they just visited my father. And they were under risk because they were in jail. They were not permitted to go out in that place. But they sacrificed themselves. They said they take risks. They took risks. They said, however it is, have God. So when you are doing something good for God, God himself will reward you. Amen. It really touched people, even my family. They were asking me, what are you doing there in Kenya? Why can't you come back and stay here? Because they don't want me to see you. So they said, what are you doing there in Kenya? After hearing that, Bishop and Mom visited my father. They said that now you are taking God back. Because they said, these people, you are really good to have. Amen. Because one thing they done, it changed all their mind. Now they cannot say, you are doing wrong there or you are. You are not a good man. Now they are sure what I'm doing here. Amen. So sacrifice as a Christian is very important and it's required for all of us. Just do something small. You don't know what you are doing. It will be allowed to others. And desire to hear the word of God. Because the Bible says in the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 7, the end is here. We don't know the end of the time it will come. Just every day, be it, I like the way that he preached. You remember one day he said, every day he got a chance. He preached like the last time. Every time you make sure that behave or be it, like the time is over. This is the time I have right now. Because I don't know about tomorrow. So do whatever, everything we can do it for. Testify that you are Christian. God's God will be others. Finally, number 8, share the word of God and reach out. That is what we say about this. I can't say that I have known Jesus Christ, born again, I'm going to the heaven, but my brothers there are going to hell. I don't care about them, I don't want to tell them about Jesus, because me, I'm satisfied. Me, it's okay, I have received Jesus. And you don't know that Jesus you have received, it's just a grace, it's not because you are good. It's not because you are another level, it's because that grace of Jesus Christ has come upon you. So reach out to someone, share what you do. Maybe he will come. I know there is a verse in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 16, that says that Jesus is long suffering, waiting for another people, so that they can receive him. They can come into the repentance. So let us reach out to people, let us know what we need, let us go and share the word of God, because this word of God is right and is true. Amen. And pursue things which is good, don't we? Book of Amos chapter 5, verse 14. It says, seek good, not evil, or pursue good, not evil, so that you can live. Amen. As a Christian, if you say we are seeking good for others, if you are seeking good for ourselves, if you are seeking good for our church, if you are seeking good for our pastors, if you are seeking good for our leaders, it means that you are going to live alone. But you are saying, Fabrice, I don't need you. You are wish, the bad things to happen to me. It will come to you. It will come to you. That's why you say seek good for other people, so that you might profit that goodness you have asked for others. Amen. As conclusion, we need to look ourselves. I was given 20 minutes. We need to look ourselves that are we really Christian? Are we behaved like Christian? Are we testified Jesus Christ whom we know? Or in ourselves, in our heart, we are backside. But outside, you are Christian. But Christian is inside you. And you know, me, I cannot judge you. But yourself, you can judge. You can say, I'm doing right. You can say, I'm doing wrong. You can say, now I have gone far. But I need to restore my soul. I need to restore my soul. I need to testify that Jesus Christ is my Lord and my Savior. I need to reach out. I need to share this word of Jesus Christ so that another people will receive it. Amen. As we think about it and we call our bishop to pray for us so that we can restore our soul, we can manage, we can be able to be real Christian. Amen. We can have a good conduct, we can have a good character, we can be merciful, we can be sacrificed, we can have love.